recently one of the Korean refugee camps, about over 6,000 people living in the camp were attacked by the troops crossed from the Burmese side. There's about 100 people. They crossed the border at night and they burned most of the big buildings and many housing, and the people are threatened to go back to Burma.
It happens that if we're in that night, about 9:45, the gunshot go on, and then including the Burmese officer. He talks, he speaks in Burmese fluently. He said, make it easy, make it easy. In Burmese, and they just go on with the attack, and the others went to the refugees inside, not the marketplace, and started burning first the hospital, the clinic of the MSF.
This is my house. It's burned down on 28th, about 10:30. They came into here and burned down all the houses. Among the all the houses, now my house is burned down. I couldn't take anything. Everything is lost in the fire. So I have no courage and no knowledge how to build my house, how to resell.
So right now, over half of the families are homeless, but still the people who home were not burned are still in the situation of very uncertain, because always they were threatened to go back to Burma, or if they don't go back, the camp will burn again, and very insecure situation.
Went around and told the people, don't be afraid, like this, you see. But when I look back to my house, you see, my house is burned down already. I'm very upset about only one thing, you see, because of all of my book is become ash. After the village burned down, you see, I have the idea. I think about it, you see. We are being human, but nonsense, you see. No meaning. We are human, and why not? Why not? We don't have a right like a human, you see, to move freedom like this, you see. But now I'm sad I'm not like a human, you see, because in day we are afraid, at night we are afraid.
Évidemment, la situation, comme vous avez pu le constater, dans les camps est très tendue. Les gens ont peur et il faut faire tout ce qu'on peut pour essayer de soulager un peu cette peur. Je crois que le meilleur moyen, c'est d'être avec eux. Depuis 10 ans, on s'oriente progressivement vers une impasse, en ce qui concerne en tout cas le futur de pas mal de gens qui vivent sur la frontière. Mais bon, comme l'objet de mon travail ici, c'est avant tout la lutte contre une forme de paludisme extrêmement résistant aux médicaments, de voir dans quelle mesure ces bouleversements dans les populations ne vont pas provoquer une explosion de cette maladie, qui est quand même une maladie redoutable, qui atteint la moitié de la population du monde. Les infections tropicales que cette population a à subir en ce moment, à mon avis, concernent tout le monde. Parce qu'un jour ou l'autre, comme je disais tout à l'heure, un jour ou l'autre, on va se retrouver avec des infections dues au paludisme qui sont intraitables, qui sont incurables. Donc il est bien évident que les moustiques n'ont pas besoin de passeport pour traverser les frontières, que les maladies ne se limitent pas à des frontières artificielles. Donc on a un problème là qui touche, je dirais, qui est un problème universel. Et je pense qu'on peut arriver à comprendre un petit peu cette situation spécifique ici au travers d'un problème de santé qui englobe l'ensemble de la population, de la région et du monde. Il faut essayer de garder un petit peu de recul et essayer de voir quels sont les moyens possibles de travailler avec cette population et avec les populations environnantes au milieu de cette tourmente. Je crois que c'est la meilleure manière de les aider aussi.
I just waiting who is helping us. I have been to Rangoon for 4 times already for peace negotiation.
We are fighting for 47 years. So the KNU is going on, but they said we want peace. As long as the SLOC call us, we will go. But we will agree when they change their proposal.
You know, the SLOC said that we're talking about peace, but they asked us to, what they call, enter into a legal form, and then to lead our arms. So for the KNU, what is a legal for? We don't know about the legal for. You have no law and order yet. You are not the government. You are not elected by the what called people in Rangoon. Only NLD. They are what got elected, but you deny them. But now what is your what called legal for? It's been the law and order.
Visit Mimaya 1986. People's desire. Oppose those relying on external elements, acting as stooges, holding negative views. Oppose those trying to jeopardize stability of the state and progress of the nation. Oppose foreign nations interfering in internal affairs of the state. Crush all internal and external destructive elements as the common enemy.
Law and order is mean the clan don't accept that, and to lead our army we don't accept that. So it's stall to proceed for peace talking. The Burmese want to eliminate us. Eliminate is one thing, but I think from my personal opinion, they want to genocide us. They want to clear us out from the war. So, but Burma is not for only Burmese, for all other ethnic groups to stay together and live together in harmony. But the SLOC don't want that.
Without any agreement, we dare not go. I told you, if we go, then we'll become a slave forever for the SLOC. The president, Bauji, the late president, have left 4 principles. First, surrender is out of question. Second, we shall retain our arms. Third, our current state must be completed. Fourth, we shall decide our own destiny. We shed our blood, we lost our lives, we lost our limbs, and we lost everything, but still fighting and fighting up till now. They try to destroy us in many ways. And the last way is that to divide the Quran by believers, just like Buddhists and Christians.
The clan are divided not by ourselves, by the slot. After that, we have also the belief, you know, about Buddhist, Christian, and the acne or something like that. And then the Burmese, I don't mean the Burmese, I mean the slot, know that, and then they could separate us.
Right now, the situation in Burma is very critical. The slog are very strong. So all the people, not only the ethnic people, also even the Burmese people who like to help the people are killed or arrested or suppressed by the military people.
After the school demonstration, the army took the power. They arrest the student and they put them in jail. They arrested already me one time, you see, for a month in jail. So after that, I'm very difficult to stay there and escape there, you see. My friend is shot by the gun, you see, in front of me, you see. This is just the smaller thing, you see. I think the world knows that already, you see. They kill many students, you see. In Rangoon. I think Aung San Suu Kyi trying for every people who stayed in Burma, you see, to get the democracy, you see. So Aung San Suu Kyi likes the mother of the democracy of Burma, you see. Maybe Aung San Suu Kyi is not come back to Burma, you see. The democracy in Burma is dead already. We can try to get the democracy in Burma because of her, I think. She will win or not, I don't know, you see, because I know also the slog government, especially the slog leader, you see, Hanu is not honest, you see, they are very tricky. The neighbor country believe him, you see. I'm afraid to go back into Burma, but I think the situation is very bad. They will continue, you see, resistant, because they did it about over 40 years. The leader is old, but we have the young people. They have idea also, you see. We want only one thing. Humanists must be human, you see? Must get the human right.
The people are hungry or in fear in Burma. So they leave the country and they try to find a way. Many people are always in fear to serve as porter or post labor in the village. Even the medical person who helped these people are arrested, and many of them were disappeared, and many of them killed in the events. So I decided to move to the border because we need to continue to for freedom of our people and to save our country. Resta pater minis in me patrique comparoris cum spiritu paraclito regiam sterum. We are originated from the north of Asia, you see. And so we started our, there are a legend, mouth to mouth.
not a scroll, because they all destroy the scroll when the rulers rule us, you see. So we got only a poem, a poetry, and a legend of a story. We are started from Babylon, you see. And Babylon, our original land, and then we came place by place to Caucasus. Then we stay at Caucasus, and come down to Mongolia, and then cross the Gobi Desert, and then come down to Tibet and to Thailand and to Burma. And we are the first migration into Burma. So related into the Bible as an Israelite, maybe the missionaries try to spot out that we are one of the lost tribes of Israel.
On estime 5 millions de Karen entre la Thaïlande et la Birmanie, et la majorité est en Birmanie. Il y a quelque chose qui est important, c'est de réaliser, et ça c'est quelque chose que j'ai réalisé avec les années, c'est qu'ils sont très réceptifs à l'étranger, l'autre. Les Karen, dans leur histoire, dans leur mythologie, détenaient le livre sacré. Et que ce livre sacré a été perdu. Mais la mythologie dit aussi que ce livre leur sera rapporté par un homme blanc. Les missionnaires qui sont venus évangéliser les Karen et d'autres tribus ont bénéficié de cette mythologie. Mais il n'en reste pas moins qu'en Karen, le mot qui les désigne en tant que peuple et en tant qu'individu, qui est Pokonyo, signifie être humain.
We are human, so we want to be human, you know, that's all. But now, I have no book, you see, so I'm like a blind people.
Tout ça nous ramène au conflit qui existe aujourd'hui et permet peut-être un peu de comprendre d'abord ce qui se passe et ensuite comment nous, en tant qu'étrangers, on peut se positionner au milieu des carrés.
What's the relationship between war and human? Why we separate, no? Thailand, Chinese, United States, why we separate it? And we make the war. I hate the war, you see. Because of the war, many people died, you see. So I hate it. I make the song, you see. And also, I heard China and Burmese, they make agreement. If they make the dam on the Salu River, especially the location people, they will have a big problem, you see. They will lose.
Mais bien sûr que les Karen vont tout perdre, non seulement au nord, mais également au sud, et peut-être avant tout au sud, du fait de la construction du gazoduc, dont Total est le principal opérateur, Total, compagnie pétrolière française, bien sûr. Ce projet a été condamné vivement, fermement et à plusieurs reprises par Aung San Suu Kyi, leader démocratiquement élu, au point qu'elle a dit que Total était devenu le principal soutien du système militaire birman. C'est un projet qui est condamnable à plusieurs égards, avant tout parce qu'il constitue un soutien moral et politique de fait à une junte militaire barbare qui est illégale, illégitime et condamnée internationalement. Ensuite, parce qu'il offre un soutien financier et économique énorme à cette même junte, et une junte qui était au bord de l'asphyxie financière. Enfin, Total a passé des accords de sécurité avec l'armée birmane, donc l'armée qui est chargée d'assurer la sécurité de toute la région du gazoduc, une armée birmane dont on connaît les méthodes brutales et sanguinaires, et de ce fait, la construction du gazoduc a occasionné des violations massives des droits de l'homme, déplacement de population sur une très grande échelle, travail forcé, violence en tout genre, viol, torture, etc. Et la population karen est bien évidemment la première à en souffrir.
So, maybe you will hear people crying. When you travel near by the river, you will hear the sound of the water running and also the bird singing, you see. But after they make the dam, you will heard very, very bad song, you see. People crying, please save the salmon.
On the